Today is a special day, and I told you it's contagious. We have another young boy who desires to be an altar boy. So at this time, we are going to bring John Barley forward and install him as an altar boy this morning.
Which is made for your honor and to John, who
Christ is risen from the dead, trampling down death by death, and to those in the tombs bestowing life. Christos voskrese, smeti smets mepo pravi sushim vorobi shivo darovav. Christ is risen from the dead, trampling down death by death, and to those in the tombs bestowing life. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill among men. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill among men. O Lord, you shall open my lips. My mouth will show forth your praise. Blessed is the kingdom of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, always, now, and ever, and forever. Christos vos crese, smert vic, smertios smert.
Thank you.
knowledge of your truth and life eternity.
Thank you. and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever.
From the Acts of the Apostles. In those days, while Paul and Luke were on their way to the place of prayer, they met a slave girl who had a clairvoyant spirit. She used to bring a substantial profit to her masters by fortune telling. The girl began to follow Paul and the rest of them, shouting, "These men are the servants of the Most High God. They will make known to you a way of salvation." She did this for several days, until finally Paul became annoyed, turned around, and said to the spirit, "In the name of Jesus Christ, I command you, come out of her." Then and there the spirit left her. When her masters saw that their source of profit was gone, they seized Paul and Silas and dragged them into the main square before the local authorities. They turned them over to the magistrates with this complaint: "These men are agitators, disturbing the peace of our city. Furthermore, they are Jews, which means they advocate customs which are not lawful for us Romans to adopt or practice." The crowd joined in the attack on them, and the magistrates stripped them and ordered them to be flogged. After receiving many lashes, they were thrown into prison, and the jailer was given instructions to guard them well. Upon receipt of these instructions, he put them in maximum security, going so far as to chain their feet to a stake. About midnight, while Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God as their fellow prisoners listened, a severe earthquake suddenly shook the place, rocking the prison to its foundations. Immediately, all the doors flew open and everyone's chains were pulled loose. The jailer woke to see the prison gates wide open. Thinking that the prisoners had escaped, he drew his sword to kill himself. But Paul shouted to him, "Do not harm yourself. We are all still here." The jailer called for a light, then rushed in and fell trembling at the feet of Paul and Silas. After a brief interval, he led them out and said, "Men, what must I do to be saved?" Their answer was, "Believe in the Lord Jesus and you will be saved and all your household." They proceeded to announce the word of God to him and to everyone in his house. At that late hour of the night, he took them in and bathed their wounds. Then he and his whole household were baptized. He led them up into his house, spread a table before them, and joyfully celebrated with his whole family his newfound faith in God.
Peace be with you, reader. It is wisdom. Let us be attentive as we listen to the Holy Gospel. Peace be unto all. A reading of the Holy Gospel according to St. John. Let us be attentive. At that time when Jesus was passing, he saw a man blind from his birth, and his disciples asked him, "Rabbi, who sinned, this man or his parents, that he was born blind?" And Jesus answered, "It was not that this man sinned or his parents, but that the works of God might be made manifest in him. I must work the works of him who sent me while it was day. Night comes when no one can work. As long as I am in the world, I am the light of the world." As he said this, he spat on the ground and made clay of the spittle and anointed the man's eyes with the clay, saying to him, "Go wash in the pool of Siloam," which means sent. So he went and washed and came back seeing. The man said, "We know that God does not listen to sinners, but if anyone is a worshiper of God and does his will, God listens to him. Never since the world began has it been heard that anyone opened the eyes of a man born blind. If this man were not from God, he could do nothing." They answered him, "You were born in utter sin, and you would teach us." And they cast him out. Jesus heard that they had cast him out, and having found him, he said, "Do you believe in the Son of God?" He answered, "And who is he, sir, that I might believe in him?" Jesus said to him, "You have seen him, and it is he who speaks to you." He said, "Lord, I believe," and he worshipped him. Christ is risen. Christos voskres. Christos anesti. I thought it would be a good idea to speak with our young children of the first confession class this morning, so please have a seat. You guys look very nice today. You're very beautiful. Your dresses are pretty. And Curtis, you look sharp, handsome young man. Between two beautiful ladies. Good for you today. Today,
we are here to celebrate today something that happened to you yesterday. Yesterday, you came into the church, and you came and you spoke with the priest, and you told him certain things that are secret things to you about things that were maybe not so perfect in your life. And he told you, and he spoke with you and told you how maybe there's a way that we can fix some of the things that are not perfect in our lives. And so we have this, and it's called First Confession. So this morning, I want to talk to you about the gospel that we read. This morning is a gospel about a man who was born blind. Do you know what it means to be born blind? He couldn't see. If you close your eyes, and could you imagine trying to walk with your eyes closed? Have you done that before at home? You bump into things. It's not easy. We use our eyes for everything. So this man was born and he couldn't see. And it was, so he had his whole life went without seeing anything. So he was poor and he was broken and he was in the dark. And it was a common belief at that time that anyone who was born with a handicap, do you know what it means to be born with a handicap? You know, anybody who was born with a handicap, the people thought that they sinned, that they were great sinners, that they were really bad people. And if it wasn't their fault, then it was their parents' fault because their parents were really bad people. And that's what they believed. And that's kind of funny belief, isn't it? But see, Jesus Christ came and they said to him, they said, is this man, is he blind because he was a sinner, because he was a bad person? And Jesus said to him, no, he wasn't a bad person. So people with handicap are not handicapped because they're bad people and God punished them. That's not true at all. People are handicapped sometimes because of human fault, because of our fault, what we have done, not what God has done. And God never punishes anyone. We mostly punish ourselves. God doesn't punish anyone. So God said, no, this man was born blind so that I could come and make him better. We've always heard of people having miracles, right, and being healed in the hospitals. See, sometimes God lets us be sick or handicapped so that he can make us better so that more people can believe in Jesus. So that was one thing that we talked about this morning. And then the second thing that we talked about was after this man was that Jesus restored his sight. Jesus gave him his sight back. He said to him, no one can work miracles through God who is a sinner. So we have to look at that and say, wow, if someone is a good person, God will listen to him. See, God doesn't listen to sinful people. God doesn't listen to evil people. God listens to people who are good. And that's what that man said. He said, God doesn't listen to sinners. You can pray as much as you want if you're a sinner, and God will not listen to you. God listens to people who are good. Who are good. And so that's another thing that we talked about today. We come to confession to make ourselves better people, right? Good people, so that God, whenever we ask something from God, he will hear us. So that's the second point I wanted to make this morning. And the third point is something interesting that happened after this man was able to see, after God cured him of his blindness, and he could see, and he could see everything and everyone. And the Pharisees became upset. The Pharisees, the leaders of the people who didn't like Jesus, they become very angry with this man because he said, Jesus healed me and I can see now. And so they said, I know. Let's get his parents, because maybe he wasn't born blind. Maybe he's just faking it, because they were mad that Jesus healed this man. He wasn't faking it. Jesus really healed him. And so they said, let's get his parents. And you know what his parents said? They hung him out to dry. Do you know what that means? No, some of your parents do. They said, let him answer for himself. He is of age. That means he's old enough to speak for himself. Now, why is that important? That's important to us today because something has changed in your life today. There's a great change today that didn't happen on Friday. There's a change because now you are of age. You are considered young adults in the church. And that means you are responsible for yourself. Do you know what it means to be responsible? That means that any time that you are bad or you do something wrong, God's not going to say to your parents, you didn't bring them up right. God's going to say to you now, what did you do? He's going to make you responsible. And so that's a great change. You have grown in 2 days because of this sacrament. You have grown and you have become responsible young people who are now going to try to be the best young Christians you can be, best followers of Jesus that you can be today, because you have now are of age and you are now responsible for all the things that you do. Now, we spoke yesterday in the confessional, right? And we made a pact, right? We made a contract. We said that if anything really ever bothers you, you can always come to the priest and he will help you through the difficulties of life. Now, you're pretty young now. You don't have a lot of difficulties, but in a few years you may. And so if you remember anything else, nothing else about this day, remember that I am always here to help you to get through the troubled times of life. And that's our contract that we have together. Okay, can we do a fist bump on that? Wonderful. Fist bump on that? Wonderful. Fantastic. Thank you very much for listening to us today. And they are very beautiful. And we will honor you today in pictures and with communion and with the grace of the Holy Spirit and the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Christ is risen. Christos voskres. Christos Anesti.
Let us all say with our whole soul and with all our mind, let us say.
O Lord, have mercy.
O Lord, almighty God of our fathers, we pray to you. Hear us and have mercy. Of Constantinople, and for our God-loving Bishop Gregory, for our esteem, for our spiritual fathers and all other clergy, and for all our brethren in Christ, for their welfare, peace, health, salvation, and for the remission of their sins, and that the Lord our God may prompt and help them in all things. Works in this holy and venerable church, for those who labor in its service, for those who sing, and for all the people here present who await your great and abundant mercy, for those who have shown us kindness, and for all Orthodox Christians. Son, and to the Holy Spirit, always, now, and ever, and forever.
Yeah.
of this country and its armed forces, the blessed and ever-remembered founders and benefactors of this holy church, for the servants of God, those who are celebrating their birthdays this week, Chad Machesco, John Hashjack, Marion Levernight, Arutum Aminov, and Rebecca Miller. For the servant of God, Leonard Messner, for safety in travel. For the servants of God, Abigail Barney, Christina Chow, and Curtis Dutko, whom we honor this day. For the servant of God, the priest John Barancho, for his health, his continued health and long life. For the servants of God, those who are joining us via the internet, for their health and long life. For the servants of God, Michael Gigak, Matushka Dorothy Timko, Irene Bross, Mary Gall, Richard Nikolinik, Michael Long, John Martich, and Elsie Deleba, for their blessed repose, and for all you Orthodox Christians, always, now, and ever, and forever.
Thank you.
Let us stand aright, let us stand with fear, let us be attentive, so that we may offer the holy sacrifice in peace. Of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. Six-winged and many-eyed who soar aloft in their wings and hood. Sing, cry out, and proclaim the triumphant hymn. Sing.
Holy, holy,
with these blessed powers, O Lord and Lover of mankind, we too cry out and say, holy are you and all holy, you and your only begotten Son and your Holy Spirit. especially for our ever holy, ever pure, ever blessed and glorious Lady, the birth giver of God and ever Virgin Mary. In the words of the Holy Father, the Lord of Christ, and not this John. Judgment seat of Christ, let us beseech the ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God. And make us worthy, O Lord, with full confidence and without condemnation, to dare to call upon you, God, our Heavenly Father, and to say to you, Spirit. Amen. I believe, O Lord, and confess that you are truly the Christ, the Son of the living God, who came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the first. O Son of God, accept me today as a communicant of your mystical supper, for I will not speak of this mystery to your enemies, for like Judas will I give you a kiss, but like the penitent thief I confess to you. O Lord, remember me when you come into your kingdom. O Master, remember me when you come into your kingdom. O Holy One, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Let the partaking of your holy mysteries, O Lord, be not for my judgment nor condemnation, but for the healing of my soul and my body. O Lord, I also believe and confess that this which I am about to receive is truly your most precious body and truly your life-giving blood, which, I pray, I may worthily receive for the remission of all of my sins and for life everlasting. O God, be merciful to me, a sinner. O God, cleanse me of my sins and have mercy on me. O Lord, forgive me, for my sins are many. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Forgive me if I have sinned against you in any way, either thought, whether voluntary or involuntary. Forgive me if I have sinned against you in any way, either thought, whether voluntary or involuntary. The precious and all holy Lord.
me, shall my sins ever everlasting. Amen. Refresh your life, give me blood.
Children of the first confession class to come forward, and Grandpa John and Uncle John will distribute the Eucharist to them. Yeah, go ahead, Marzo, get him on.
Thank you.
this has touched your lips and shall take away your iniquities and shall cleanse you of all of your sins. O God, save your people and bless your inheritance. Christ is risen.
Thank you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Christ is risen. Christos voskres. Christos anesti. Have a seat a moment. Birthday greetings are extended today to Chad Machesco, to Marion Levernight, to John Haschak, to Artur Aminov, and to Rebecca Miller. We will have a testimonial dinner here at our Christ the Savior Educational Center Tuesday, May 26th, to honor Helen Spanovich on her retirement. Donate $25 per person. You can find a form in the church auditorium. Camp Nazareth News. I'm assuming that everyone has successfully registered their child online for camp. We have sent our share, the church's share, and the Sunday school share in already. So if you haven't, please let me know, or please do it. You can save $20. Deadline is passed. Never mind. Leave taking for the Feast of the Resurrection is this Wednesday. Leave taking is the last day of the feast. The Feast of the Ascension of our Lord is Thursday. Divine Liturgy, 9 a.m. Vespers, Wednesday evening at 4 p.m. Special time, 4 p.m. Please contact me if your child is graduating high school or college so we can set graduation date. It looks like graduation date. Graduation Sunday is May 31st. Please contact me if you have a child graduating college. Memorial Day crept up on us kind of fast this year. It is next Monday, and so we will bless the graves on Sunday. Next Sunday, we will bless the graves. I have here on the tetrapod on the sacramental table grave blessing forms, as well as in the back and downstairs. If you would like to have your family grave blessed, please fill out the form and give it back to me, please. Return it to me. Much to read in a bulletin, young women's encounter information, details for these and much, much more found in the bulletin. We will have a panahita this morning for Michael Gigak, for Matushka Dorothy Timko, for Irene Bross, for Mary Gall, Richard Nikolinik, Michael Long, John Martich, and Elsie Deleba. We also welcome back, we haven't seen you for a while, Donna Zizan. It's good to see you back in your proper place in the pew here. We welcome you back. You look very well. So we hope that you're doing well, and it is blessed that you are back with us. This weekend is kind of cool for us priests. Within 3 days' time, we have done all of the sacraments of the church. Within 3 days, and it's always exciting and blessing to do that. First, we had a funeral, which is kind of sad, but it was for George Tremko, who was in his 90s. So we had a funeral on Friday, and then we had the sacrament of penance, reconciliation for the children Saturday morning. We had a wedding Saturday afternoon in Ambridge. Seminarian Will Bennett was married to Ileana Rigetti in Ambridge, so we had a sacrament of holy matrimony. We had the Divine Liturgy. We have a baptism this morning, Tristan Scott Bowser. So we have a baptism this morning. And we did the sacrament of holy unction, visiting the hospital where Father John Baranshaw was in the hospital. We pray for him. He had a mild heart attack. He told me to make sure I said mild heart attack. And he had some stints put in. So we pray for him, that John, that you have continued health, to have you back at the altar when you're strong enough.
Thank you.
Thank you. Last but not least, we have certificates for our first confession young children. And so we will call them up at this time. And then I'm going to have the altar boys and Father John come up. We're going to do a group picture right away, because I'm not sure if it's raining outside or not. And then later on, after the panahita, we can do separate pictures, and you can stay as long as you'd like to take pictures. But we'll do a group picture first. But first, let us call them forward.
We have first here in alphabetical order, but they're backwards alphabetically. That's okay. We can do it this way. Christina Leilam Cha. This is for you. And we have also Curtis Christian Butler. Then we're going to have the altar boys come out, sub-deacon, so we can take a group picture now. And and someone will take a picture. And all the boys on this side, some on the other side. What do you want me to write, brother?
Yes.
John didn't want to let his sister have one up on him, so he became an altar boy today. So do you
risen from the dead, trampling down death by death, and to those in the tombs bestowing life, through the prayers of his most pure mother, through the prayers of a holy father among the saints, John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, and through the prayers of the man born blind, whom we remember this sixth Sunday of Pascha, and through the prayers of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for he is gracious and he loves mankind.
Rise in risen.
God, Holy Mighty One, Holy Immortal One, have mercy on us. And of the Holy Spirit, now